Turn with me in your Bibles to Matthew 6, 9 through 10.
Vaya conmigo a su Biblia, Mateo 6, del 9 al 10.
There was no ring in the first service.
No había sonido en el primer servicio.
Hallelujah. Matthew 6,
Mateo 6,
9 through 10 says, "Pray then in this way, our Father who is in heaven, hallowed be your name.
Vosotros pues orad.
Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven." How many of you need the kingdom of God to come on earth as it is in heaven?
¿Cuánto necesita que venga el reino a la tierra como en el cielo?
I need the kingdom of God on earth as it is in heaven.
Necesito el reino de Dios en la tierra como en el cielo.
Amen.
Amen.
How do we go about doing that?
¿Cómo alcanzamos eso?
Hebrews 4:12.
Hebreos 4:12.
Hebrews 4:12 says the word of God is living and active and full of power, making it operative, energizing, and effective. It is sharper than any two-edged sword, penetrating as far as the division of the soul and spirit, the completeness of a person, and of both joints and marrow, the deepest parts of our nature, exposing and judging the very thoughts and intentions of the heart. So the word of God is living, active, and full of power. So if we're going to bring heaven on earth, then we need to understand that that's all about the word of God becoming living, active, and full of power here on the earth.
La palabra de Dios es activa, viviente y vivificada aquí en la tierra. Si vamos a entender este versículo.
And here in the Amplified Bible,
y en la Biblia amplificada,
when we make it living, active, and full of power,
cuando lo hacemos viviente y lleno de poder,
it tells us that's making the word operative.
Lo está diciendo que hace la palabra operativa.
It's making the word energized.
La hace energizada.
And making the word effective.
Y la hace efectiva.
The word cannot become operative.
La palabra no puede ser operativa.
If we don't become doers of the word.
Si no nos convertimos en hacedores de la palabra.
There is no operating of the word.
No hay una operación de la palabra.
Unless we become doers of the word.
Al menos que nos convirtamos en hacedores. Amen.
We got to not just know the word,
tenemos que no solamente saber,
but we've got to do the word.
Tenemos que hacer la palabra.
A lot of times we're waiting for the word to do something, and the word is waiting for us to be active.
Muchas veces esperamos que la palabra haga algo, pero está esperando por nosotros.
And then it says making it energized.
Y después dice haciéndola energizada.
So we can't just be a doer of the word by speaking it out of our mouths.
No solamente podemos hacer hacedores hablando la palabra.
But the word's got to become living.
Pero la palabra tiene que ser
vivificada. It's got to become energized.
Tiene que ser energizada.
So when you take the word of God,
para que cuando tomes la palabra de Dios,
and you begin to do the word of God,
y comienzas a hacer la palabra de Dios,
there's an energy. Has anybody ever heard somebody say, "Oh, I go to that church and I feel the energy"?
Hay una energía. ¿Has escuchado alguien decir que viene a esta iglesia y siente energía?
That's the word of God.
Esa es la palabra de Dios.
That's the spirit of God.
Es el espíritu de Dios.
And we need to understand,
tenemos que entender,
that as we live out the word of God,
que mientras vivamos la palabra de
there's
Dios,
an operative energy,
hay una energía operativa,
that begins to fill the atmosphere,
que comienza a llenar la atmósfera,
that begins to fill the situation,
que comienza a llenar la situación.
It doesn't matter what the situation is.
No importa la situación que sea.
Just like the lightning right now.
Así como el trueno.
Don't get scared.
No se asuste.
We live in Florida. It's lightning all the time.
Hay trueno todo el tiempo.
All the time.
Todo el tiempo.
If it's around 1 o'clock to 3 o'clock, it's going to rain. There's going to be lightning.
Si es alrededor de las 1 a las 3, trueno.
But how about if when there's a situation,
pero tal vez si hay una situación,
that ain't acting like the kingdom,
que no está actuando como el reino,
we would just live the word.
Si vivimos la palabra.
Just like the lightning came.
Así como vino el trueno.
Right? Just like that thunder.
Así como el trueno
vino. Is the way you should be thundering on your situation with the word.
Así debe estar tronando sobre la palabra.
And you see how it got, everybody went like this.
Y ves como todo el mundo miró.
Como si podía ver algo.
As if you could see something.
Porque lo que yo veo es un pared.
Because what I see is a wall.
Pero ustedes están buscando, I don't know.
But you're looking at, yo no sé.
When the situation comes,
cuando una situación viene,
we've got to understand,
tenemos que entender,
that the only thing,
que la única cosa,
that's going to change that situation is the word of God.
Que va a transformar esa situación en la palabra de Dios.
If we make it operative,
si lo hacemos operativo,
and energized by doing it,
y energizada haciéndolo,
it'll be effective on that situation.
Va a ser efectivo sobre esa situación.
Amen.
Amen.
So if you want the kingdom of heaven on earth,
si tú quieres el reino de Dios en la tierra,
we've got to start with the word.
Tenemos que comenzar con la palabra.
We've got to start by being doers of the word.
Tenemos que comenzar siendo hacedores de la palabra.
It has to be your first reaction to every situation.
Tiene que ser tu primera reacción a toda situación.
It can't be a second, third, or fourth place type of thing.
No puede ser segundo, tercero.
It has to become your first reaction.
Tiene que convertirse en tu primera reacción.
Has anybody ever got cut off by a car?
¿Alguien ha sido cortado el pastelillo con un carro?
What's your first reaction?
¿Cuál es tu primera reacción?
Because whatever your first reaction is,
porque cualquiera que sea tu primera reacción,
that's probably the same reaction.
Esa tal vez es la misma reacción.
When something is going wrong in your life,
cuando algo está mal en tu vida,
trust me.
Confía en mí.
You know, if you're the type of person,
si eres el tipo de persona,
that starts yelling at the car next to you,
que comienza a gritarle al carro a tu
the
lado,
car can't even hear you.
El carro ni te puede escuchar.
The window's not even down.
La ventana ni siquiera está bajada.
But you're yelling at that car.
Pero está gritándole.
You're yelling at the person in the car.
Está gritándole a la
but
persona.
You know, as soon as they look at you, you go.
Pero sabes que cuando te miran hace.
That's what you do with the situation.
Eso es lo que hace con la situación.
You start talking. But as soon as the situation confronts you with some more pressure,
y tan pronto la situación te confronta con presión,
you get stuck.
Te estancas.
Your first reaction has to be the kingdom.
Tu primera reacción tiene que ser el reino.
Your first reaction has to be this word.
Tu primera reacción tiene que ser la palabra.
It must be your first reaction.
Tiene que ser tu primera reacción.
Otherwise, heaven can't come on earth for you.
En otra manera, el cielo no puede venir a la tierra por ti.
Because you just made way for something else.
Porque hiciste camino para otra cosa.
Amen.
Amen.
So if you want the word of God to be operative, energized, and effective,
si quieres que la palabra de Dios sea operativa, energizada y operando,
it's got to be first.
Tiene que ser primero.
It's got to be what we do.
Tiene que ser lo que hacemos.
It has to become a habit.
Tiene que ser un hábito.
Because trust me, whatever you're doing is your habit.
Porque confía en mí, lo que tú haces es tu hábito.
Right? I'm originally from New York.
Yo originalmente soy de Nueva York.
So, you know, when I learned how to drive a car,
cuando yo aprendí a manejar un carro,
if a taxi driver cut me off,
si un taxi cab me cortaba,
I would rush to get in front of him and cut him off.
Yo me iba delante de él y lo cortaba también.
And one time somebody cut me off,
y una vez alguien me cortó,
so I ran my car right into the back of them.
Y yo corrí, le pegué con mi carro detrás.
Why?
¿Por qué?
Because my first instinct was to always respond the same way according to what they were doing.
Porque mi primer instinto siempre era responderle lo que me estaban haciendo.
And eventually that escalated.
Y eventualmente eso escalaba.
See, eventually the word will escalate in your life if you make it your first.
Eventualmente la palabra va a escalar en tu vida si lo haces primero.
It will become effective.
Será efectivo.
We've got to allow the word to become operative, energized, and effective.
Tenemos que permitir que la palabra sea operativa, energizante y efectiva.
It's living, it's active, it's full of power.
Está viva, está activa, está llena de poder.
It is sharper than any two-edged sword. So it's sharper than a two-edged sword.
Es más es una espada más cortante que doble filo.
Right? It penetrates as far as the division of the soul and the spirit.
Que penetra hasta la coyuntura de los tuétanos.
So heaven on earth.
El cielo en la tierra.
When I put the word to practice.
Cuando pongo la palabra a práctica.
The word of God.
La palabra de Dios.
If I put that first.
Si pongo eso primero.
Then it'll divide my spirit from my soul.
Va a distinguir mi espíritu de mi alma.
So that it doesn't affect me by way of the soul, but rather by way of my spirit.
Para que no afecte mi alma, sino mi espíritu.
So that my old nature is not what's handling the situation, but my new man is.
Para que mi vieja naturaleza no maneje la situación, sino mi nueva naturaleza.
Because the word of God is always going to come and divide.
Porque la palabra de Dios siempre va a venir a dividir.
It's going to divide that which is of the earth and that which is of heaven.
Va a dividir lo que es de la tierra y lo del cielo.
That which is of this kingdom and that which is of his kingdom.
Va a dividir lo que es de este reino y lo del reino de él.
So if we want to stop acting earthly or in our old nature,
si queremos parar de actuar terrenales y nuestra naturaleza carnal,
we have to allow the word of God,
tenemos que permitir la palabra de Dios,
to divide,
dividida,
even to the bone marrow, it says. It'll split the soul and the spirit.
Va a dividir el alma y el espíritu hasta las coyunturas.
Of both joints and marrow.
De las coyunturas y los tuétanos.
The deepest parts of our nature.
Lo más profundo de nuestra naturaleza.
So what is he trying to do?
¿Qué está tratando de
hacer? He's trying to get into the deepest parts of our heart.
Quiere llegar a lo profundo de nuestro
corazón. Has anybody ever seen an actual bone, the inside of a bone?
¿Alguien ha visto un hueso, lo de adentro de un hueso?
It has marrow.
Tiene tiene
marrow. Just say marrow. Don't marrow. Worry about it. What?
Tuétano. Médula ósea.
I don't know. Eso mismo lo que dijeron ellos. But the bone,
pero el hueso,
on the inside of it,
por dentro de ello,
is what is holding it together.
Es lo que lo está aguantando.
On the inside of it is what's giving it life.
Adentro de ello es lo que da vida.
So God wants to come and split our old nature from our new nature.
Dios quiere dividir la naturaleza vieja de la nueva.
So that we can get to the life of God.
Para que lleguemos a la vida de Dios.
So that we can bring heaven on earth.
Para que traigamos el cielo a la tierra.
So we got to understand,
tenemos que entender,
that we can't sit down and just wait for something to happen.
Que no podemos sentarnos a esperar que algo ocurra.
As doers of the word,
como hacedores de la palabra,
the very word will cause something to happen.
La palabra causará que algo ocurra.
But sometimes we just sit around,
pero a veces nos sentamos,
waiting for something to happen.
Esperando que algo ocurra.
We sit around thinking that something's supposed to happen.
Nos estamos esperando que, estamos pensando que algo ocurra.
And the word is waiting for us to do something.
Y la palabra está esperando que nosotros,
the word is waiting for us to release something.
La palabra está esperando que desatemos algo.
The word wants to become operative, energized, and effective.
La palabra quiere convertirse en operativa, energizante, y poderosa en nuestra vida.
Just because you know the word,
solo porque conoces la,
doesn't mean you do the word.
No quiere decir que haces la palabra.
There's a lot of people who know the word,
hay muchos que conocen la palabra,
but they live in sexual immorality.
Pero viven en inmoralidad sexual.
So because, so if they, how can you live in sexual immorality and know the word?
¿Cómo puede vivir en inmoralidad sexual y conocer la palabra?
Because you're not doing the word.
Porque no estás haciendo la palabra.
Because it's doing the word,
porque en haciendo la palabra,
that makes it operative, energized, and effective.
Que la hace operativa, energizada y efectiva.
Not just knowing the word.
No solo conocer la palabra.
That's why a theologian,
por eso teologistas,
he knows the word,
conoce la palabra,
but he doesn't walk in miracles, signs, and wonders.
Pero no camina en señales, milagres, y prodigios.
He's not operating in the thing that he knows.
No está operando en aquello que conoce.
You ever read a sci-fi book?
¿Ha leído libros científicos?
Right, a sci-fi book, maybe they talk about aliens.
Un libro científico, tal
they
vez
talk about stuff that isn't real.
De cosas que no son verídicas.
So you know the book, but you can't live that book.
Conoces el libro, pero no puedes vivir ese libro.
Right?
¿Verdad?
But the word, we're supposed to know it and live it.
Pero la palabra debemos de conocerla y vivirla.
Amen?
Amen?
So if you're going to bring heaven on earth,
va a traer el cielo a la tierra,
you've got to allow the word to become living, active, and full of power in you.
Tienes que permitir que la palabra se vuelva vivificante, activa y llena de poder en ti.
Amen.
Amen.
Matthew 7:24-27.
Mateo 7, del 24 al 27.
It's when you do this,
es cuando hagas esto,
that you begin to build on the foundation.
Que comienzas a edificar sobre la fundación.
The foundation we call the rock.
La fundación que llamamos piedra.
It says, so everyone who hears these words of mine and acts on them. So this is exactly what we're talking about here.
Esto es lo que estamos hablando.
Are you hearing the word and acting on them?
¿Estás escuchando la palabra y actuando sobre
ella? Or do you just hear the word and say amen and go home and don't act on it?
O solamente escuchar la palabra y decir amén y te vas a la casa y haces lo mismo.
Because the only way the word is going to become living, operative, and effective.
Porque de la única manera que la palabra va a ser vivificante y efectiva en tu vida.
Operative, energized, and effective.
Operativa, energizante y efectiva.
Is if we begin to act on the words that we hear.
Es si actuamos sobre las palabras que escuchamos.
Amen.
Amen.
If you do that, you're like a wise man, si a far-sighted prayer. You don't have to do the scripture. They can read it. Okay? And then it'll go faster. So everyone who hears these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man, a far-sighted, practical, and sensible man who built his house on the rock. Anybody want to be wise?
¿Quiere alguien ser sabio acá?
You see, many are waiting for the spirit of wisdom, and the spirit of wisdom is waiting for you.
Muchos están esperando el espíritu de sabiduría y el espíritu de sabiduría te está esperando a ti.
Because wisdom,
porque la sabiduría,
is to apply,
es aplicar,
that which you know and understand.
Aquello que conoces y entiendes.
So when you apply that which you know and understand,
cuando aplicas lo que conoces y entiendes,
now you're walking in wisdom.
Ahora estás caminando en sabiduría.
And that which you build,
y aquello que edificas,
you're building on the rock.
Edificas sobre la piedra.
25. And then fell the rain, and the floods and torrents came, and the winds blew and slammed against that house, yet it did not fall, because it had been founded on the rock. When you build on the rock,
cuando fundas sobre la roca,
whatever you're building is not going to fall.
Lo que edificas no se va a caer.
Whatever you're building can be built on top of.
Aquello que construyes puede ser construido encima.
God wants to do more for you in your life.
Dios quiere hacer más para ti en tu vida.
But we've got to be doers of the word.
Pero tenemos que ser hacedores de la palabra.
Because as doers of the word,
porque como hacedores de la
palabra, we become builders of the word.
Somos edificadores de la
palabra. As we build the word,
como edificamos la
palabra, we're expanding his kingdom.
Estamos expandiendo su
reino. As we expand his kingdom,
mientras expandimos su
reino, he fills us with the more.
Él nos llena con más.
So that we can continue to do more and more for him.
Para hacer así más para él.
But if you, then go to verse 26.
Si vas al verso 26.
And everyone who hears these words of mine and does not do them. So if you don't do the word,
si no haces la palabra,
then you're like a fool.
Eres como tonto.
The Bible says you're stupid.
La Biblia dice que eres tonto.
A stupid man who built his house on the sand.
Un hombre insensato que edificó su casa sobre la arena.
So how many of you know we all are sitting in this place right now?
¿Cuántos de nosotros sabemos que todos estamos pecando?
We're all hearing the same word.
Estamos escuchando toda la misma palabra.
Some of us will apply it.
Algunos lo aplicamos.
And some of us won't.
Y algunos no.
Because Jesus,
porque Jesús,
was on a mountainside.
Estaba en la montaña.
Preaching this same word.
Predicando la misma palabra.
So Jesus was talking to a people.
Jesús estaba hablando a un pueblo.
That heard the same word.
Que escuchó la misma palabra.
From the same mountainside.
La misma montaña.
During the same time.
En el mismo tiempo.
And yet not all of them
y aun todo de ellos
left to be wise.
Se fueron para ser sabios.
Some of them left to be foolish.
Algunos se fueron para ser
what
sabios.
Was the difference?
¿Cuál fue la diferencia?
The ones who acted on the word that he released,
aquellos que actuaron en la palabra que él desató,
were the wise ones.
Eran los sabios.
And what they were building would not be destroyed.
Y lo que edificaban no iba a ser destruido.
But the ones who left and did not act.
Pero los que se fueron y no actuaron.
The ones who left and did not study.
Los que se fueron y no estudiaron.
The ones who left and did not try to gain an understanding of how to apply it in their lives.
Los que se fueron y no trataron de tener un entendimiento de su vida.
The ones who left and completely forgot they were even just in church.
Los que se olvidaron de que estaban aún en la iglesia.
The ones who left.
Los que se fueron.
And allowed the situation to overcome them.
Y primero que la situación los venciera.
The ones who left and kept everything else first except for his kingdom.
Los que se fueron y permitieron que todo lo demás fuera primero que su reino.
Fools.
Tontos.
And everything they built.
Y todo lo que edificaron.
Let's go to the next verse.
Vamos al próximo verso.
Was destroyed.
Fue destruido.
And the Bible says the rain fell and the floods and torrents came and the winds blew and slammed against that house and it fell. And great and complete was its fall. Meaning,
significa
that when you build on the sand, when you build on the things of this world,
cuando edificas sobre la arena en las cosas de este mundo,
what you're building will not last.
Lo que está edificando no va a permanecer.
And when it's destroyed, it's going to be completely destroyed.
Y cuando es destruido, será completamente destruido.
You know what the problem is?
¿Sabes cuál es el problema?
We go back and try to build it again.
Vamos y regresamos y tratamos de levantarlo de nuevo.
We don't learn from our lesson.
No aprendemos la lección.
We
literalmente
go back and try to do it again.
Regresamos a hacerlo otra
Somebody
vez.
Gets married.
Alguien se casa.
They build it on worldly stuff.
Lo hace sobre cosas mundanas.
The marriage is destroyed.
Matrimonio se destruye.
They get married again.
Se casan de nuevo.
And they do the same things they did in the first marriage.
Y hacen lo mismo que hicieron en el primer matrimonio.
And they're expecting everything to change.
Y están esperando que todo cambie.
Because we're always willing to blame somebody else.
Porque siempre estamos dispuestos a culpar a otros.
Instead of making the changes we need to change for ourselves.
En vez de hacer los cambios que tenemos que hacer nosotros mismos.
Amen.
Amen.
How many want heaven on earth?
¿Cuántos quieren el cielo en la tierra?
It's not going to happen if you don't do the word.
No va a ocurrir si no haces la palabra.
It's just not going to happen, guys.
No va a ocurrir.
Okay. You, listen, there are principles on the earth, laws.
Hay principios y leyes en la tierra.
That whether you're a sinner.
Que sea tu pecador.
Or a child of God.
O un hijo de Dios.
Those laws are in effect for all of us.
Esas leyes están en efecto para todos.
You're going to reap what you sow.
Vas a cosechar lo que siembras.
But just because you reap well.
Pero solamente porque cosechas.
Doesn't mean you're building.
No significa que estás
edificando. On the rock.
Sobre la piedra.
That's why millionaires will kill themselves.
Por eso millonarios se suicidan.
Because they have built everything on the world system.
Porque han edificado todo en el sistema del
mundo. On the sand.
En la arena.
And so foolishly they build.
Tontamente ellos edificaron.
Foolishly they're very prideful.
Tontamente son orgullosos.
Because they think they got it all, they know it all.
Porque se cree que lo saben todo y tienen
todo. They think they're being fulfilled with money.
Se cree que está siendo lleno con el dinero.
And then the money
después el dinero
causes them to demand a certain respect, a certain honor.
causan que ellos demanden un respeto y un honor.
The money tells them that they can get whatever they want.
El dinero les dice que pueden conseguir lo que quieren.
The money tells them
el dinero les dice
that people have to treat them a certain way.
Que el pueblo lo tiene que tratar de una manera.
But money don't fulfill you.
Pero el dinero no te llena.
And if money don't fulfill you,
si el dinero no te llena,
what it buys ain't gonna fulfill you.
Lo que compres no te va a llenar.
You have to understand that.
Tienes que entender eso.
And so these people that you see that they look successful because of money.
Estas personas que tú ves que parecen tener éxito por dinero.
Number one, you don't know the kingdom because money don't say you're successful.
Número uno, no conoces el reino porque
the kingdom is made up of peace, joy, and righteousness.
El reino está hecho de paz,
so if you think that money
si tú piensas que el dinero
is what the kingdom looks like,
es lo que aparenta ser el reino,
or you're wrong.
Estás equivocado.
Because the kingdom looks like peace, joy, and righteousness.
Porque el reino parece como paz,
now,
gozo,
will,
y justicia.
Can he give you riches?
¿Te puede dar riquezas?
Can you be a good steward?
¿Puede ser buen mayordomo?
And have money?
¿Y tener dinero?
Why, surely you can.
Pues claro que sí.
No doubt.
Sin duda.
But that's not the measure of success.
Pero eso no es la medida del éxito.
Because there's a lot of people with money that ain't got no peace.
Porque hay muchos que tienen dinero que no tienen paz.
There's a lot of people with money that ain't got no joy.
So hay muchos con dinero sin gozo.
And surely you know there's a lot of people with money that ain't got no righteousness.
Y hay muchos con dinero que no tienen justicia.
Righteousness is to be in right standing with God.
La justicia es estar bien parado delante de Dios.
So that just eliminated every sinner.
Eso eliminó todos los pecadores.
Whether they got money or not.
Si tienen dinero o no.
Every sinner just got eliminated.
Todo pecador ha sido eliminado.
Joy is eternal.
El gozo es eterno.
It's not happiness.
No es contentura.
There's a difference between being happy
hay una diferencia, ser contento,
and having joy.
Y tener gozo.
Happy is temporal.
Estar contento es temporal.
I'm happy because it's my birthday.
Estoy contento porque es mi cumpleaños.
I'm happy because I paid my bills.
Estoy contento porque pagué mis
but when you can't pay your bills next week, you ain't gonna be happy no more.
Pero cuando no puedes pagar los bills la semana
but
que viene,
when you've got
contento,
joy,
pero cuando tienes gozo,
you got joy because your joy comes from the Lord.
Tiene gozo porque viene del Señor.
So joy is eternal.
El gozo es eterno.
Money can't rob you of joy.
El dinero no te puede robar el gozo.
Listen, you have to understand that.
Escucha, tienes que entender eso.
Some people don't have peace.
Algunos no tienen paz.
When they ain't got money.
Cuando no tienen dinero.
But when you got God.
Pero cuando tienes a Dios.
You always have peace.
Siempre tienes paz.
So don't ever measure a person's success. See, if you measure somebody's success based on how much money they have.
No midas el éxito de una persona por el dinero. Si lo basas en ese, en el éxito.
Then your standard is on a worldly system.
Entonces tu estandarte está en el espíritu del mundo.
And what you're lifting up is going to come tumbling down.
Y lo que estás levantando se va a caer.
Because that means your standard is built on sand.
Porque tu estándar está edificado sobre la arena.
Amen.
Amen.
So don't, you know, some people strive. They think the more money they make, the more successful they are.
Algunas personas luchan por el dinero y se creen que mientras más tienen, más exitosos son.
That's just not true.
Eso no es la verdad.
According to the world, it's true.
De acuerdo al mundo, es real.
But God's truth is greater.
Pero la verdad de Dios es mayor.
Joy.
El gozo.
Peace.
Paz.
Righteousness.
Justicia.
That's what his kingdom is made of.
De eso se trata su reino.
Joy. Peace.
Gozo, paz.
Righteousness.
Justicia.
That's the standard of God.
Ese es el estandarte de Dios.
Amen.
Amen.
So if you want to bring heaven on earth,
si quieres traer el cielo a la tierra,
you got to do it by way of the word.
Tienes que hacerlo de la manera de la palabra.
When you do it by way of the word,
cuando lo haces por medio de la palabra,
you're like the wise man who builds on the rock.
Eres como el hombre sabio que edificó sobre la piedra.
Now why do you want to do this?
¿Por qué quieres hacer esto?
It's interesting if you go to Matthew 7:21-23.
Es interesante si va a Mateo 7 de 21 a 23.
You'll find out before Jesus starts talking about this foundation.
Vas a ver que antes de que Jesús hable de esta fundación.
He's talking about who's going to make it into heaven.
Él está hablando de quién va a llegar al cielo.
How many of you want to make it into heaven?
¿Cuándo quieren entrar al cielo?
So it says here in Matthew 7:21, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only he who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. Many will say to me on that day when I judge them, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in your name and driven out demons in your name and done many miracles in your name? Now, the only people that can say this,
lo único que pueden decir esto,
it ain't sinners.
No son pecadores.
It's people that think they saved.
Son personas que creen que son salvos.
Because trust me, sinners,
confía en mis pecadores.
You know, they're not trying to cast out demons.
No están tratando de echar fuera demonios.
Sinners ain't trying to do miracles in his name.
Pecadores no están tratando de hacer milagros en su nombre.
That means he's talking to people that were sitting in a pew.
Quiere decir que estaban hablando a personas sentadas en sillas, en bancas.
En sillas en la iglesia.
In seats in the church.
Vamos a dar directo.
Let's be direct.
Porque podemos sentar en una silla en los cines.
Because we can sit in a theater seat.
Pero estoy hablando de las sillas que están en la iglesia.
I'm talking about the seats inside the church.
Silla donde hay gente que está escuchando la palabra.
Seats where people are listening to the word.
Y la palabra de Dios.
And the word of God.
Sillas que hay gente.
Seats where there are people.
Que están sacando demonios.
They're casting out demons.
Pero no están viviendo como debe de estar vivir allí afuera.
But they're not living how they should live out there.
Que están
there.
Entrando a la iglesia, están profetizando.
They're coming in church and prophesying.
Pero cuando salen por ahí, no están viviendo vida que son santo.
When they walk out, they're not being holy.
Porque ellos están subiendo una casa.
Because they're coming to a house.
No en Jesucristo.
They're edifying a house, not on Jesus Christ.
Pero en el mundo.
In the world.
En el mundo.
In the world.
Y están en la iglesia.
And they are in the church.
So God.
Entonces Dios.
In his infinite wisdom.
En su sabiduría infinita.
Relates to us here.
Nos habla a nosotros acá.
That there's going to be people.
Que va a haber un pueblo.
That are going to be judged.
Que va a ser juzgado.
That he's not going to know.
Que él no va a conocer.
That they think they know him.
Que se creen que lo conocen a él.
Because they prophesy.
Porque profetizan.
They casted out demons.
Echaron fuera demonios.
See, that's why if you ever heard you can't cast out what you're dealing with.
Si ha escuchado no puede echar fuera lo que usted está tolerando.
A house divided cannot stand.
Una casa dividida no puede prevalecer.
Sometimes a demon will let you think you cast them out just so you can leave the person alone.
A veces un demonio te hace creer que lo echaste fuera para que lo dejes tranquilo.
And because your foundation is on sand, you don't have the discernment to know that you actually didn't cast out a demon.
Y que por tu fundación está sobre la arena, no tienes el discernimiento para
saber que lo echaste fuera. Or it happens all the time.
Pasa todo el tiempo.
You know, there are soothsayers.
Hay personas que... Soothsayers.
I don't know how you say that in Spanish. Dulcen palabras. Endulcen las palabras.
Sweet sayers.
Those are, you know the psychics out there?
¿Sabe los psíquicos allá afuera?
You know, if you drive to St. Cloud on 192 on the right-hand side, it says a real big sign, psychic.
Si vas a San Cloud a la mano derecha, hay un signo grande que dice psíquico.
That's a soothsayer.
Esa es una persona que habla lindo.
She's going to tell you the sweet word.
Palabra dulce.
But you know they tell you a sweet word according to your heart.
Te dice palabra dulce de acuerdo a tu corazón.
Sometimes prophets do that too and they don't even realize it.
A veces profetas hacen eso también y ni se dan cuenta.
God will prophesy to you according to your heart.
Dios va a profetizarte de acuerdo a tu corazón.
That's in the Bible.
Eso está en la
Biblia. I ain't got time to teach that right now, but that's in the Bible.
No tengo tiempo para enseñar eso, pero está en la Biblia.
So these people,
este pueblo,
who think they know God,
que cree que conocen a Dios,
are not going to be allowed into his kingdom.
No van a ser permitidos en su
reino. Go to 23, please.
Verso 23.
I don't think I have 23. Yeah, I do. And then I will declare to them publicly, I never knew you. Depart from me. You are banished from my presence. You who act wickedly, disregarding my commands. So these are the very scriptures right before he talks about foundation.
Estas son las primeras escrituras antes de hablar de la fundación.
So what is he telling us?
¿Qué nos está diciendo?
He's telling us
está diciendo
that his word
que su palabra
is crucial for our life.
Es crucial para nuestra vida.
That if we're not doers of his word,
si no somos hacedores
everything
de su palabra,
we build in this world
todo lo que edifiquemos en este mundo
will crumble
se va a caer
when we get to his world.
Cuando lleguemos a su mundo.
Because only those things that are eternal are going to make it into the kingdom of God.
Porque solo aquellas cosas que son eternas van a llegar al reino de Dios.
Your body is not eternal.
Tu cuerpo no es eterno.
Your spirit is.
Tu espíritu es.
That's why you have to crucify the lust of the flesh.
Por eso tiene que crucificar la lujuria
Because
de
when
la
you
carne.
Crucify the lust of the flesh, you'll do his word.
Porque cuando crucifica la lujuria de la carne, vas
And
a hacer
when
su
you
palabra.
Do his word,
cuando hace su palabra,
you'll become acceptable in his kingdom.
Vas a ser aceptable en su reino.
Why? Because you can only do his word by the spirit.
Porque solo puedes hacer su palabra por el Espíritu.
So if it's only by the Spirit,
si es solo por el Espíritu,
that's why he's seeking those who will worship him in spirit and in truth.
Por eso él busca adoradores en espíritu y en verdad.
Because he's looking for one who by the Spirit does his truth.
Porque está buscando que aquellos por el Espíritu hagan su verdad.
Because that word there,
porque esa palabra ahí,
right? He's looking for those in spirit and in truth.
Está buscando en espíritu y en verdad.
Those who will worship him.
Aquellos que le adoren.
Worship isn't singing a song.
Adoración no es cantar una canción.
Worship is about the way you live.
Adoración es la manera que
see,
vives.
Your life is a worship unto him.
Tu vida es una adoración ante
your life.
Tu vida.
Everything you do is
haces.
Supposed to be done as a worship unto him.
Se supone que se haga una adoración para
so
él.
When I talk to my wife,
cuando le hablo a mi esposa,
am I speaking to her as a worship unto him?
Estoy hablándole a ella como una adoración.
How do I learn how to speak to her as a worship unto him?
¿Cómo aprendo a hablarle a ella como una adoración ante él?
By allowing this word
permitiendo que la palabra
to become living,
se convierta
to become active.
Activa.
See, when I allow this word
yo permito esta palabra,
to become operative, energized,
que sea operativa, energizante,
it becomes effective.
Sea efectiva.
And that this word
esta palabra,
from living waters, from the depths of my belly,
de la profundidad de mi vientre,
begin to flow through my actions,
comienza a fluir por
begin
mis acciones,
to flow through the words that come out of my mouth,
comienza a fluir de la palabra
and they
que
become
de mi
boca, a worship unto him,
se convierte en una adoración ante
but
él,
a blessing unto her.
Pero una bendición para ella.
The word.
La palabra.
Do you know that the word says,
¿sabes tú que la palabra dice?
That we should look at everything good.
Que debemos de mirar a todo bien.
That when we think of our brothers and our sisters, we should think the best of them.
Que cuando miramos a nuestro hermano y nuestra hermana, pensemos lo mejor de ellos.
So if you're not thinking the best of them,
si no estás pensando lo mejor de ellos,
then you're not doing the word.
Entonces no estás haciendo la palabra.
So then how can you build a relationship with somebody,
¿cómo puedes edificar una relación
that you're not
con alguien?
Thinking the best of them?
Que tú no piensas lo mejor de
because
ellos.
It's whatever you think in your mind,
es lo que piensas en tu mente,
that's going to flow from your heart.
Va a fluir de tu corazón.
So if I think the worst of you,
si pienso lo peor de
then
ti,
what's going to flow from me
lo que va a fluir
is
de mí,
the worst of you.
Es lo peor de ti.
And how can I build you up?
¿Y cómo te puedo levantar?
But not instead,
pero independiente,
I become a curse in your life.
Soy maldición en tu vida.
But if I think the best of him,
pero si pienso lo mejor de él,
now I'm taking this word,
estoy tomando esta palabra,
I'm stirring it up on the inside,
la estoy moviendo adentro.
He comes in,
él viene,
he got dreadlock type hair,
él tiene el pelo así con
he
trenzas,
look like a rasta,
se parece un rasta.
I don't know,
yo no sé.
I don't know if I could trust this guy,
no sé si lo puedo confiar.
Cause you know something in the world told us a perspective with those that look like rastas, right? Let me go to Barry. Barry got that hair too, right? Barry
tiene ese pelo.
You know, you look at Barry, oh, this guy, he must be I don't want to say the word because then I'll be cursing in the church. But, you know, he looked like that kind of guy who's always smoking that rifa. He looked like that kind of guy that don't, he just want to kill people. You know, because that's what, you know, I grew up in New York and Gun Hill Road. There was a whole bunch of guys that this is what they looked like. And they were known for killing people and for doing things that they shouldn't do.
Se parece al rasta como Barry. Yo me crié en Gun Hill Road, que se parecían como él, que lo que hacían era que fumaban weed y disparaban.
Sorry, Barry. So when I look at Barry now,
cuando miro a Barry ahora,
I gotta look at him with the word.
Yo tengo que mirarlo con la palabra.
I can't look at what I grew up with.
No puedo mirarlo como nos criamos.
Because if I look at what I grew up with,
si miro lo que me crié,
oh, I'm going to think the worst of Barry.
Voy a pensar lo peor de él.
Barry ain't got no chance with me.
Barry no tiene oportunidad
conmigo. And I might be the very thing he needs.
Y tal vez yo soy lo que él necesita.
So that he can get saved.
Para que se pueda salvar.
So am I a blessing or a curse?
Estoy bendiciendo,
that's contingent on whether I have the word.
Eso es contingente a la palabra.
On the inside of me.
Si la tengo dentro de
whether
mí.
I allow it to become operative.
Si la permito que sea
whether
operativa.
I allow it to become energized.
Si la permito que sea energizada.
So that it can become effective.
Para que sea efectiva.
Right, wives with your husbands.
Esposa con sus esposos.
Right, Socorro, wives with your husbands.
¿Verdad, Socorro?
She can't look at Richie for what he's doing right now.
No puede mirar a Richie por lo que está haciendo ahora.
She's got to look at Richie with the word.
Tiene que mirar a Richie con la palabra.
See, speaking the word to him to try to get him to change, that's not cleansing him, that's frustrating him.
Hablarle la palabra para que él cambie no lo está limpiando, lo está.
You want to know what cleanses him?
¿Sabe lo que lo limpia?
When she stays in covenant with God.
Cuando ella se queda en pacto con
when
Dios.
When she believes the promise of God.
Cuando ella cree la promesa de Dios.
When she says, I believe your promise.
Cuando yo,
And instead of getting mad,
y en vez de enojarse,
instead of getting frustrated,
en vez de frustrarse,
she goes to prayer.
Ella va a la oración,
and she begins to pray for him.
Comienza a orar
and
por
she
él.
Begins to intercede for him.
Comienza a interceder
and
por
now
él.
She's working with the covenant of God.
Ahora está caminando con
she's
el pacto
responding
de Dios.
To God's covenant with covenant.
Está respondiendo al pacto
she's,
con pacto.
She's causing the promises of God to be released
está causando que las promesas de Dios sean desatadas.
Through her prayer.
A través de su oración.
Through her intercession.
A través de su intercesión.
What is she doing with the word?
¿Qué está haciendo con la palabra?
She's causing it to be active, living, breathing.
Está causando que sea activa,
and that
viviente,
word,
esa palabra.
She won't, she's not going to talk word to him.
No va a hablarle palabra.
She's got to see him with the eyes of God.
Lo va a ver con los ojos de
and
Dios.
And she does that as she enters covenant with God.
Si entra así cuando está impactado
and
con
now
Dios,
with the eyes of God,
con los ojos de Dios,
she begins to treat her husband with love like she's never treated him before.
Comienza a tratarlo como amor como
she
nunca
begins
antes.
To love on her husband like she's never loved him before.
Comienza a amarlo como nunca antes.
Because the covenant with God releases a love on the inside of her
desata un amor dentro de ella
that is now released on her husband. And so her covenant cleanses her
entonces el pacto la limpia
so that her heart can be pure
para que su corazón sea puro
and love on the husband that needs to be transformed.
Y ama al esposo que tiene que ser transformado.
Because he can't be transformed
porque él no puede ser transformado
if the word isn't cleansing him
si la palabra no lo limpia
in action.
En acción.
Not trying to shove it down his throat.
No tratando de ponerlo bajo su boca.
The proverb says.
Proverbio dice.
Divinely directed decisions are on the lips of the king.
Decisiones directas son del rey.
His mouth should not transgress in judgment.
Su boca no debe de hablar. Justicia.
Why you keep telling me you're gonna do something and then you don't do it?
¿Por qué me dices que vas a hacer algo y no lo haces?
Just like the proverb says.
Así como dice el proverbio.
You're not a good king.
Tiene un buen rey.
That's not cleansing with the word.
Eso no es lavando con la palabra.
That's judging with the word.
Eso es juzgando con la palabra.
And he didn't call you to judge your husband.
Él no te llamó a juzgar a tu
he called
esposo.
You to help your husband.
Te llamó a ayudarlo.
He called you to lift him up in prayer.
Te llamó a levantar
he called you
en oración.
To intercede for him.
Te llamó a interceder por
he
él.
He called you to look at him through the eyes
te llamó a verlo con
of
los ojos
fire.
De fuego.
That's what he called you to do.
A eso te llamó.
Husbands, you could give me money at the back door later.
Esposo, me dan el dinero en la puerta ahorita.
Yeah, because sometimes
sí, porque a veces
we think that cleansing
creemos que la limpieza
is repeating the word to somebody.
Es repitiendo la palabra a alguien.
That's not cleansing.
Eso no es limpieza.
Cleansing is applying the word in your life.
Purificación es aplicar la palabra en tu vida.
So that you can live a life that loves all those around you.
Para que vivas una vida que amen todos los que están a tu alrededor.
So that you can release the love of God.
Para que desates el amor de Dios.
See, there's some people that won't experience the love of God until you're transformed.
Hay algunas personas que no experimentarán el amor de Dios hasta
there's some people that need to experience the love of God in you and through you.
Hay personas que necesitan experimentar ese amor en
ti. And the only way you're going to be able to do that is if you're in covenant with God.
Y de la única manera que lo lograrás es en pacto con Dios.
If you got to be in covenant.
Tienes que estar en pacto.
See, what is this foundation all about?
¿De qué se trata esta fundación?
It's all about covenant.
Se trata de pacto.
Covenant is between two people.
Pacto entre dos personas.
Covenant is knowing that God made promises.
El pacto es sabiendo que Dios hizo promesas.
And he's going to keep those promises.
Y él va a mantener esas promesas.
But there's something on our end that we got to do.
Pero hay algo que nosotros tenemos que hacer.
See, what do we got to do?
¿Qué nosotros tenemos
que hacer? We got to become doers of the word.
Tenemos que ser hacedores de la palabra.
You want God's word to come in your life and manifest?
¿Quieres que la palabra de Dios se manifieste en tu vida?
Then you got to become a doer of the word.
Tienes que ser hacedor de la palabra.
That's exactly what he's talking about in the book of Matthew.
De eso es lo que habla en el libro de Mateo.
When you think about Matthew 7,
cuando piensa en Mateo 7
and building on the rock or building on sand
edificando sobre la piedra o arena,
what determines whether you build
¿qué determina lo que tú
whether
edificas?
You're a doer of the word
si eres hacedor de la palabra.
When you're a doer of the word
cuando eres hacedor de la palabra,
you begin to fulfill covenant promise with God
completa el pacto, la promesa con Dios.
That's why the Bible says
la Biblia dice,
if you love me,
si me amas,
you'll obey my commands
obedecerás mis mandatos.
Well, where are you going to get his commands from?
¿De dónde vas a conseguir su
the mandato? Only place you're going to get his commands from
solo lo vas a conseguir
it's from the word.
En la palabra.
And when you get these down,
y cuando entiendas
then
esto,
come and talk to me about the small still voice inside of you.
Entonces ven a hablarme de la voz dentro de ti.
Because a lot of people
porque muchas personas
want to say God said,
quieren decir Dios dijo,
but what God told them ain't aligned with this word.
Pero lo que Dios le dijo no está alineado con la palabra.
And they don't even know it because they don't read the word.
Y ni lo saben porque no leen la palabra.
These are the words of his.
Estas son sus palabras.
That we have to do to build on the rock.
Que tenemos que hacer para edificar sobre la
These
piedra.
Are the words.
Estas son las palabras.
Amen.
Amen.
These are the words.
Estas son las palabras.
Let's go to Ezekiel 36, 33 to 36.
Vamos a Ezequiel 36, 33 al 36.
It says, thus says the Lord God, on that day that I cleanse you from all your sins, I will also cause the cities of Israel to be inhabited, and the ruins will be rebuilt. So I want you to understand something here.
Quiero que entienda algo acá.
It says, thus says the Lord God.
Sí, dice, así dice el Señor.
On the day that I cleanse you from all your sins.
En el día que yo lo limpio de vuestros iniquidades.
What day did he cleanse you from all your sins?
¿Qué día te limpió?
On the day of your salvation.
El día de tu salvación.
On the day of your salvation.
El día de tu salvación.
Did you need deliverance from some things?
¿Necesitaba liberación de alguna
cosa? Of course you did.
Claro que sí.
Did you stop every single sin in your life?
¿Paraste todos los pecados en tu vida?
Of course you didn't.
Claro que no.
Because you're not even aware of every sin in your life yet.
Que ni siquiera conoces todos los pecados en tu vida todavía.
When you first get saved, you just know to stop doing what the world knows as sin.
Cuando tú llegas a salvación, lo que entiendes que tienes que dejar es lo que el mundo conoce como pecado.
But you don't stop doing what God knows is sin.
Pero tú no dejas de hacer lo que Dios conoce como pecado.
Because your foundation is on the world.
Porque tu fundación está sobre
so
el mundo.
How can you know something that you have no foundation in?
¿Cómo puedes conocer algo que ni siquiera tiene la fundación de?
And yet,
y aún,
on the day that he cleanses you from all your sins,
en el día en que él te limpie de todas vuestras
iniquidades, he will also cause the cities to be inhabited.
Hará que las ciudades sean habitadas.
So what does that mean?
¿Qué significa?
On the day you got saved,
en el día que tú te salvaste,
he made a covenant agreement with you.
Él hizo un pacto de acuerdo contigo.
See, this is a promise.
Esto es una promesa.
Anytime you see a promise,
cada vez que ves promesa,
you can know
puedes saber
that that's the covenant of God.
Que es el pacto de Dios.
Anytime you see a promise in the word,
cada vez que ves una promesa
God
en la palabra,
is saying
Dios está diciendo,
he's going to do something for you.
Él va a hacer algo por ti.
That's covenant.
Eso es pacto.
Now what you got to know,
lo que tienes que saber,
is that in every covenant,
en todo pacto,
there's two people.
Hay dos personas.
So if God's making a promise to you,
si Dios te está haciendo una promesa,
you the second person,
tú eres la segunda persona,
and he's expecting something from you now.
Y él espera algo de ti ahora.
Right?
¿Verdad?
So he says, on the day that I cleanse you from all your sins.
Él dice, en el día que yo lo limpié de vuestras
iniquidades. So there's an expectation that you're going to accept Jesus Christ in your heart.
Hay una expectativa que vas a recibir a Jesús en tu corazón.
You do that, he cleanses you of all your sins.
Tú haces eso, él te limpia de todos tus pecados.
I will also cause the cities to be inhabited.
Y haré que las ciudades sean habitadas.
So he cleanses you of your sins.
Te limpia de tus pecados.
And immediately your spirit man comes alive.
Y inmediatamente tu espíritu se vivifica.
When your spirit man comes alive,
cuando tu espíritu se vivifica,
everything you need,
todo lo que necesitas,
everything he wrote about you,
todo lo que él escribió de ti,
comes alive.
Se vivifica.
You just don't know it's there because you don't know.
Tú no sabes que está ahí, tú no sabes.
Because you have no foundation.
Porque no tiene fundación.
And what you don't have a foundation and you can't know.
Y lo que no tiene fundación él no puede saber.
So you might, that's a covenant of God.
Es un pacto de Dios.
He then goes on to say,
él después dice,
thus says the Lord God, on the day, what's going on? There you go. The desolate land will be cultivated instead of being a desolation in the sight of everyone who passes by. So you got to understand this.
Tú tienes que entender esto.
The desolate land will be cultivated.
La tierra desolada será cultivada.
You just got saved.
Tú te acabas de salvar.
You didn't know anything.
Tú no sabías nada.
So now your heart has to be cultivated.
Ahora tu corazón tiene que ser cultivado.
So that cultivated instead of being desolate.
Cultivado en vez de ser desolado.
So that means he's going to start digging through your heart.
Significa que él va a acabar tu
corazón. He's going to start loosening the rock heart that you have.
Va a empezar a aflojar la
corazón. He's going to start causing the ground to be softened.
Va a causar que tu corazón sea suavizado.
That's why you get saved Sunday, you come back next Sunday.
Por eso te salvas domingo y regresas el domingo.
And you're like, oh.
Y dice, oh.
I didn't know I had to stop that too.
Yo no entendía que tenía que dejar eso también.
Why?
¿Por qué?
Because he's cultivating.
Porque está cultivando.
So now your heart isn't empty anymore.
Ahora tu corazón ya no está vacío.
But rather it's being cultivated.
Pero aún está siendo cultivado.
Because God just brought your spirit man alive.
Porque Dios vivificó tu espíritu.
And everything you need is on the inside of you.
Y todo lo que necesitas está dentro de ti.
But he's got to loosen the soil.
Pero tiene que arar la tierra.
So he can start bringing those things that were dead back to life.
Para traer las cosas que estaban muertas a la vida.
You know where everything was dead and you didn't have nothing. Now all of a sudden there's something there.
Lo que estaba muerto no había nada y ahora hay algo ahí.
You have problems, but you didn't know how to deal with them.
Tenías problemas y no sabías cómo lidiar.
But because he's cultivating your heart.
Pero porque está cultivando tu corazón.
Now you know how to deal with them.
Ahora sabes cómo lidiar con ellos.
Because he begins to what? Release his knowledge of who he is to you.
Porque comienza a desatar el conocimiento de quién él es a ti.
And it says that it's going to happen in the sight of everyone who passes by.
Y dice que va a ocurrir a la vista de todos los que pasen.
What does that mean?
¿Qué significa?
People are going to notice that you're changing.
Las personas van a ver que estás cambiando.
This is all covenant language.
Esto es lenguaje de pacto.
This is all a promise of God.
Esto es todo una promesa de
Dios. We've been learning about covenant.
Hemos estado aprendiendo de pacto.
So he's telling us what he's going to do for us.
Lo que va a hacer para nosotros.
Once we accept his son in our life.
Cuando aceptemos a su hijo en
nuestra
vida.
Can we go to 35?
Vamos al 35.
And then they will say, this land that was deserted and desolate has become like the Garden of Eden, and the waste, desolate and ruined cities are fortified and inhabited. So he's telling you.
Te está diciendo.
In all them people that talked about you.
Todas esas personas que hablaron de ti.
All them people that said you'll never amount to anything.
Todas las personas que dijeron nunca alcanzarás
nada. All them people that said you was useless and worthless.
Todas las personas que decían que tú no valías nada.
You know what I'm talking about? All them people that said you should have not have married that man.
Todas las personas que decían no te hubieras casado con ese hombre.
You know all those people.
¿Sabes tú esa gente?
All them people that said.
What
they used to say about me. They used to say a lot of bad things about me.
¿Qué decían de mí? Decían muchas cosas malas.
But one of the things they used to say is that I wouldn't live past 30.
Pero una de las cosas que decía que
I was a little too crazy.
Pasado de 30 porque yo era un poco.
Well, let me tell you, I'm 55.
Pero déjame decirte, tengo
55. I'll be 56 in 2 months.
Seré 56 en 2 meses.
And I am living the abundant life of Jesus Christ.
Y estoy viviendo la vida abundante de Jesucristo.
Okay, and what he's doing in my life is absolutely amazing.
Y lo que él está haciendo en mi vida es absolutamente asombroso.
I'm humbled to be living this life.
Estoy humildemente viviendo esta vida.
Because truly, truly, I'm only alive because of the King.
Porque verdaderamente estoy vivo solo por el rey.
That's the only reason.
Esa es la única razón.
Because this land was desolate.
Porque esta tierra era desolada.
This land was in ruin.
Esta tierra estaba en ruinas.
And if there's one thing I know.
Sí, una cosa que yo sé.
Surely I could not have done what I have done up to this point without him.
Te aseguro que no podría hacer lo que he hecho hasta este punto sin él.
So it says the land that was deserted and desolate has become like the Garden of Eden.
Dice que la tierra que era desolada se ha convertido como el huerto del Edén.
When God
Cuando Dios
put Adam in the Garden of Eden,
puso a Adán en el huerto del Edén,
Adam had everything he needed.
Adán tenía todo lo que necesitaba.
And when God found that he was missing something,
y cuando Dios vio que le faltaba algo,
God provided her.
Dios lo proveyó.
Her name was Eve.
Se llamaba Eva.
Because God said,
porque Dios dijo,
it is not good for man to be alone.
No es bueno que el hombre esté solo.
So that means
significa,
God wants to put you in a place
Dios quiere ponerte en un lugar
where you're no longer desolate,
a donde no eres
where desolado, you're no longer alone,
a donde no estés solo.
You have everything you need,
tienes todo lo que necesitas,
you're protected,
eres protegido,
and you have a perfect helpmate.
Y tienes una ayuda idónea.
It's all covenant language.
Es todo lenguaje de pacto.
This is all covenant.
Es todo pacto.
This is all a promise.
Es todo promesa.
This isn't this scripture, by the way.
Esta escritura
is the first time I ever heard the voice of the Lord.
Fue la primera vez que escuché la voz del Señor.
He spoke this scripture to me.
Él habló esta escritura a mi vida.
I didn't even know what the scripture was.
Yo ni sabía lo que era la escritura.
I had no clue.
No tenía.
I had to go to somebody.
Tuve que ir a alguien.
And tell them, yo.
Y decirle, hey,
I'm hearing voices in my head.
Estoy escuchando voces en mi cabeza.
And this is what it's saying.
Y esto es lo que me está diciendo.
And it sounds like an old English man.
Y suena como un hombre inglés.
Because I'm hearing the thuses and the thous, and I'm like, what is this?
Y dice vosotros y aquellos.
And a pastor, his name is Pastor Gilbert.
Y un pastor, Pastor Gilbert.
He took me to this scripture.
Me llevó esta escritura.
And showed me that it was the Lord that was speaking to me.
Y me enseñó que era el Señor que me estaba hablando.
You have to understand, I didn't even know where Genesis was, let alone Revelation.
Tienen que entender que yo no sabía dónde estaba Génesis ni siquiera Apocalipsis.
I didn't know the Bible.
No conocía la Biblia.
But when I got saved,
pero cuando me salvé,
everything that I needed was put on the inside of me.
Todo lo que necesitaba fue puesto
when I got saved,
cuando me salvé,
he began to cultivate my heart.
Comenzó a cultivar mi corazón.
When I got saved,
cuando me salvé,
I began to hear his voice.
Comencé a escuchar su voz.
Listen, I couldn't speak in tongues for a whole year.
Escucha, yo no podía
hablar. Because I couldn't get out of my head.
Porque no podía salir de
mi cabeza. I don't know what these people are talking. I'm not talking that stuff.
¿De qué están hablando esta gente? Yo no
I thought they was crazy.
Yo decía que estaban locos.
For a whole year.
Por un año.
But I surely heard the voice of God.
Pero te aseguro escuché la voz de
because
Dios.
He was whispering this scripture in my ear.
Porque él me estaba susurrando esta escritura en mi oído.
And he began to tell me this land that was deserted and desolate has become like the Garden of Eden.
Y me decía esta tierra que era desolada se convirtió en la, el huerto del Edén.
And the waste, desolate, and ruined cities are fortified and inhabited.
Y los desiertos desolados y arruinados serán fortificados.
He was making covenant with me.
Estaba haciendo pacto conmigo.
He was telling me what he was going to do with me.
Me estaba diciendo lo que iba a hacer conmigo.
He was telling me, I know you ain't got nothing and you're destroyed and you feel like you want to give up on life.
Me estaba diciendo, yo sé que estás destruido y quieres darte por
vencido. But you're saved now.
Pero eres salvo.
And because you're saved now.
Y porque eres salvo ahora.
I'm going to give you everything you need.
Te voy a dar todo lo que necesites.
You'll be on the earth, but it'll be like you're in the Garden of Eden.
Vas a estar en la tierra, pero como en el huerto.
Where I will provide, I will protect.
Yo voy a proveer y proteger.
And I will prosper you.
Y te voy a prosperar.
You have to understand this is covenant language.
Tienes que entender que esto es idioma de pacto.
And this scripture is not just for me, it's for everybody in here.
Esta escritura no es solo para mí, pero para todos.
All of us.
Todos.
All of us.
Todos.
Are becoming undeserted.
Estamos siendo sin desierto.
All of us are becoming like the Garden of Eden.
Todos nos estamos convirtiendo en el
Every single one of us.
Cada uno de nosotros.
If we'll enter into a covenant with God.
Si vamos y nos hacemos con pacto con Dios.
You have to do your part.
Tienes que hacer tu parte.
For me, my part was very simple.
Para mí, mi parte era bien sencilla.
I made a covenant with God to wake up every day at 5:00 in the morning.
Yo hice un pacto con Dios a levantarme todos los días a las 5 de la mañana.
And read His word.
Y leer su palabra.
That was easy for me.
Eso fue fácil para mí.
Because I was in the military.
Porque yo estaba en la militar.
And in the military.
Y en la militar.
I had to wake up at 5:00 in the morning every day.
Yo tenía que levantarme a las 5 todos los
It
días.
It didn't matter if I hung out all night and came home at 3:00 in the morning.
No importaba si salía y llegaba a las 3 de la mañana.
I was up at 5:00 in the morning.
Tenía que estar de pie a las 5.
I was running 3 miles.
Estaba corriendo 3 millas.
I was doing push-ups and sit-ups
and
jumping jacks and all that kind of exercise because we had to work out every day. So if I could do that in the military, how much easier was that going to be when I go to sleep at 11 o'clock at night? Right? So I made a covenant with God. I'm going to get to know who you are. I'm going to read your word. And as I started reading His word,
y mientras yo leía su palabra,
I started doing His word.
Comencé a hacer su palabra.
And when I started doing His word,
y cuando comencé a hacer su palabra,
it became alive on the inside of me.
Se vivificó dentro de
All of a sudden, it became operative.
De repente era operativa.
All of a sudden, it was as if though there was an energy in my life that I never had before in my life.
De repente era una energía que tenía en mi vida que anteriormente
And the word was becoming effective.
Y la palabra estaba siendo efectiva.
I was no longer cheating at work.
Ya no estaba chireando en el
I was
trabajo.
Working as if I was working unto the Lord.
Estaba trabajando como para Dios.
Because the Lord gave me this scripture.
Dios me dio esta escritura.
And then He gave me a scripture out of the Proverbs.
Y después me dio una escritura de los
If
Proverbios.
You see a man who walks in excellence.
Si ves un hombre que camina en excelencia.
You see a man who will stand before kings.
Vas un hombre que se levanta delante
And I didn't really know what that meant.
Yo no sabía lo que eso era.
But what I did know
Pero lo que sí sabía
was what was excellence.
Lo que era excelencia.
And I started to walk in excellence.
Y comencé a caminar en excelencia.
And 1 year
y un año
of doing everything that God was telling me to do,
haciendo todo lo que Dios me decía,
my whole life was changed.
Mi vida toda fue cambiada.
We struggled that first year.
Luchábamos primer año.
That first year was a difficult year for us.
El primer año fue bien difícil para
that
nosotros.
First year I was paying tithe.
Ese primer año yo diezmaba.
And I didn't even know why I was paying tithe. I just knew I needed to pay tithe.
Y ni sabía por qué lo estaba haciendo, solamente sabía
I didn't know the blessing behind it. I didn't know nothing.
No sabía la bendición tras ello ni nada.
But something in my heart told me you got to tithe.
Pero algo en mi corazón decía, tú tienes que
diezmar. Something in my heart told me that I got to read the word every day.
Algo en mi corazón decía yo tenía que leer la palabra todos
Something
los días.
In my heart told me that I got to do the word that I'm reading.
Algo en mi corazón decía yo tengo que hacer la palabra que
estoy
leyendo.
And to do the word that I was reading.
Y para hacer la palabra que estaba leyendo.
I remember I bought a study Bible.
Yo recuerdo que
Because I didn't understand the word.
Porque no entendía la palabra.
So I would read the word.
Leía la palabra.
And then I would read the notes.
Y leía las notas.
Oh, that's what that means.
Oh, eso es lo que significa.
And that's how I learned to do the word.
Y así aprender a hacer la palabra.
The Holy Spirit taught me.
El Espíritu Santo me enseñó.
And then I would go to church on Sunday. And the pastor would preach, and I would take notes. You can ask my wife. I still have the notebooks at home.
Todavía tengo las libretas en mi casa.
Of when I would take notes for every single service.
De cuando tomaba las notas de cada
I would
servicio,
take notes.
Tomaba notas.
At the end of the service, if the Lord told me to do something, I would write it.
Al final del servicio, si el Señor me pedía algo, yo
Throughout the day, if the Lord would tell me to pray for somebody or somebody said, pray for me.
Durante el día si el Señor me decía que orara por alguien,
I would write it down.
Yo lo escribía.
Because I was developing a discipline.
Porque estaba desarrollando una disciplina.
To complete my covenant with God.
para completar el pacto con Dios.
I was developing a discipline.
Estaba desarrollando una disciplina.
To be a doer of the word.
Para ser un hacedor de la palabra.
Because you'll never be a doer of the word if you're not disciplined.
Nunca vas a ser un hacedor de la palabra si no tienes disciplina.
You'll never be a doer of the word if you don't study the word.
No vas a ser hacedor de la palabra si no la estudias.
You're never going to apply what you don't know.
Nunca vas a aplicar lo que no conoces.
And you'll never apply correctly what you don't understand.
Y no vas a aplicar correctamente lo que no entiendes.
So you've got to be a studier of the word.
Tienes que ser un estudiante.
You've got to be a student of the Holy Spirit.
Tienes que ser un estudiante del Espíritu
Santo. It's part of your covenant.
Es parte de tu pacto.
If you want what God has for you,
si tú quieres lo que Dios tiene para
you
ti,
have to live out your covenant with God.
Tienes que vivir tu pacto con Dios.
And I'm telling you,
te digo,
if you're not praying,
si no estás orando,
if you're not worshiping,
si no estás adorando,
if you're not studying at home,
si no estás estudiando en su casa,
if you're not making sure that what the pastor that you're under,
si no aseguras lo que está debajo de tu pastor,
taking what he or she says,
tomando lo que ellos te dicen,
and applying it in your life, if you're not doing that,
y aplicarlo a tu vida, si no lo estás
then
haciendo,
you're not fulfilling your covenant.
No estás completando tu pacto.
And what you're waiting for, what he has promised you,
lo que está esperando, lo que él te ha prometido,
will not come to pass.
No va a suceder.
You have to complete your covenant.
Tienes que completar tu pacto.
You have to walk in covenant with God.
Tienes que caminar en pacto con Dios.
A lot of people think it's by how we feel.
Muchas personas se creen como me siento.
It don't matter how you feel.
No importa cómo te
if
sientes,
God tells you,
si Dios te dice,
this is the place I want you,
este es el lugar que te quiero,
then this is the place he wants you.
Entonces, este es el lugar que te quiere.
And if he wants you in that place,
si te quiere en ese lugar,
then this is the word he wants you to hear.
Este es la palabra que
and
quiere
if
que
this
escuches,
is the word he wants you to hear,
y si este es la palabra que quiere que escuches,
then this is what you're supposed to be acting on.
Entonces, actúa en
and
esto.
If this is what you're supposed to be acting on,
si esto se supone que tú
then this is where you're supposed to build.
Entonces,
and
que
it don't matter what you feel.
No importa.
What matters is that you obey God.
Lo que importa es que obedezcas.
Obey God.
Obedece.
Obey God.
Obedece a Dios.
And we wonder
y nos preguntamos
why we're frustrated.
Porque estamos frustrados.
Because we're not obeying God.
Porque no estamos obedeciendo a Dios.
Because when you obey God,
cuando obedeces a Dios,
he fulfills you.
Él te llena.
When you obey God,
cuando obedeces a Dios,
his peace comes upon you.
Su paz viene sobre
when you obey God,
cuando obedeces a Dios,
his joy comes upon
su gozo
you.
Viene sobre
when you obey God,
cuando obedeces a Dios,
you become righteous because you get into right standing with God.
Te conviertes en justo porque estás justo delante de
and
Dios.
When you come into right standing with God,
y cuando estás en justicia delante de Dios,
when you come into right standing with God,
cuando estás caminando recto delante de Dios,
that's when he begins to release his covenant promises with you.
Ahí él desata las promesas de pacto sobre ti.
And let me tell you what the Bible says.
La Biblia dice,
don't give grudgingly.
No des con un corazón quejando.
Right? It's better that you don't give.
Es mejor que no des.
Than to give grudgingly.
Que des con un corazón con queja.
Well, that doesn't just apply to money.
Eso no solamente aplica al dinero.
It applies across the board.
Aplica en todo.
You cannot be in a church and be in that church grudgingly.
Tú no puedes estar en esa iglesia con queja.
And think
y creer
that you're going to get what you're supposed to get from that church.
Que vas a recibir lo que debes de recibir de esa iglesia.
Because your honor,
porque honra,
is the currency of the exchange.
Es la moneda del intercambio.
Honor is the currency of exchange.
La honra es la moneda del intercambio.
If you're not honoring,
si no estás honrando,
then you can't receive.
No puedes recibir.
Because you are not operating in the currency of exchange.
Porque no estás operando en la moneda de intercambio.
When you are doing something begrudgingly,
cuando estás haciendo algo con queja,
you stop the exchange with heaven.
Paras el intercambio con el cielo.
Because in order to exchange with heaven, there has to be honor.
Para intercambiar con el cielo, tiene que haber honra.
There has to be honor.
Tiene que haber honra.
Let's go to verse 36 and close.
Vamos al verso 36 y vamos a cerrar.
Then the nations that are left around you will know that I, the Lord, have rebuilt the ruined places and planted that which was desolate. I, the Lord, have spoken and will do it. You know, it says, then the nations that are left around you.
Dicen, y las naciones que se quedan a vuestro alrededor.
He's talking about the people that are left around you.
Él está hablando del pueblo que está alrededor de ti.
That word nations there is the word ethnos.
Esa palabra naciones es ethnos.
And ethnos has to do with a group of people that are doing the same thing.
Y él no tiene que ver con un grupo de personas que están haciendo lo mismo.
So the people that you used to do the same thing with,
las personas que tú hacías lo mismo con,
they're going to be left around you.
Ellos van a estar alrededor de ti.
And they will know that God is rebuilding you.
Y van a saber que Dios te está reedificando.
The people that you used to hang out with before you came to church, when they see you, they go, oh, something's different about you.
Las personas con las cuales tú salías antes de venir a la iglesia van a decir, oh, algo ha cambiado en ti.
See, Until God takes you to the nations, you got to understand your nations are right around you.
Tienes que entender que antes de que Dios te lleve a las naciones, tienes que reconocer las que están alrededor de ti.
Don't think where you're not, think where you are.
No pienses a donde no estás, piensa a donde estás.
And that'll get you to where you need to be.
Y eso te llevará a donde tienes que estar.
Because a lot of people want to think they're someplace that they're not.
Porque muchas personas quieren pensar que están en un lugar que no están.
I get it. Maybe God promised that to you.
Yo entiendo, tal vez Dios te prometió eso.
But you're not living over there yet.
Pero no estás viviendo allá todavía.
You're living right here.
Estás viviendo acá.
And the nations around you here need to see that you've been rebuilt.
Y las naciones alrededor de ti aquí tienen que ver que tú has sido rebuilt.
In order for you to get to where you need to get to.
Para que alcances a donde tienes que llegar.
Amen.
Amen.
And he says, I, the Lord, have spoken and will do it.
Él dice, yo el Señor he hablado y lo haré.
How many of you have promises from God?
¿Cuántos de ustedes tienen promesas de Dios?
How many of you are waiting on promises from God?
¿Cuántos están esperando promesas de Dios?
I believe that there's a people.
Yo creo que hay un pueblo.
In this room.
En este salón.
That God wants to cause their promises to come to pass.
Que Dios quiere cumplir sus promesas.
I believe there's a people in this room.
Yo creo que hay un pueblo en este salón.
That God is calling to a greater level of covenant.
Que Dios está llamando un nivel mayor de pacto.
And that greater level of covenant.
Y ese nivel mayor de pacto.
Is going to require.
Va a requerir.
That you do His word.
Que tú hagas su palabra.
That you act on His word.
Que actúes sobre su palabra.
It's going to require.
Va a requerir.
That you align yourself within His kingdom.
Que te alinees en su reino.
You've got to be aligned in the kingdom.
Tiene que estar alineado en el reino.
To be promoted in the kingdom.
Para ser promovido en el reino.
You can't do it begrudgingly.
No puede hacerlo con queja.
You must do it with great honor.
Tiene que hacerlo con gran honor.
God wants to accomplish.
Dios quiere cumplir.
His word in your life.
Su palabra en tu vida.
That prophetic word that you received.
Esa palabra profética que
that hasn't recibiste. Come to pass.
Que no se ha cumplido.
There's a level of honor that you must come to.
Hay un nivel de honra a la cual tienes que llegar.
Those promises for your family.
Esas promesas para tu familia.
There's a level of covenant that you must come to.
Hay un nivel de pacto que tienes que llegar.
You see, covenant
pacto
has to do with His promise.
Tiene que ver con su promesa.
And your response.
Y tu respuesta.
Honor.
Honra.
Honor.
Honra.
God is looking for a response of honor.
Dios está buscando una respuesta de honra.
There's a lot of. There are different callings here today.
Hay muchos llamados acá hoy.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Father, we worship you.
Padre, te adoramos.
We exalt you, Lord.
Te exaltamos, Señor.
Father, awaken the promises.
Padre, despierta las promesas.
Awaken the promises.
Despierta las promesas.
Awaken the prophetic words released in their lives.
Despierta las palabras proféticas de
I declare an awakening.
Declaro un despertar.
An awakening now.
Un despertar ahora.
An awakening now.
Un despertar ahora.
Father, where your covenant would come alive.
Padre, que tu pacto se vivifica.
And honor would be its response.
Y la honra será la respuesta.
They would honor your covenant.
Honrarán tu pacto.
For a great exchange.
Para un intercambio grande.
Hallelujah. Father, right now in the name of Jesus,
Padre, ahora en el nombre de Jesús,
I declare an awakening.
Declaro un despertar,
an awakening.
Un despertar,
an awakening.
Un despertar,
of your promises.
Tus promesas.
Remind your people, Lord.
Recuerda a tu pueblo, Dios,
what you have promised them.
Lo que le has prometido.
Remind your people, Father.
Recuerda a tu pueblo,
what you have revealed to them.
Lo que le has revelado.
An awakening.
Un despertar.
Yes, Lord. Yes, 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 Lord. You know, when I was worshiping,
cuando estaba adorando,
the Lord began to show me the call of God on your life.
Señor comenzó a mostrarme el llamado de Dios sobre tu vida.
To the fivefold ministry.
Para el ministerio quíntuple.
And there's a great demand on the both of your lives.
Sobre los dos.
A great demand.
Una gran demanda.
And the Lord is calling you higher.
El Señor te está llamando más alto.
The Lord is there are nations.
Hay naciones.
That He has written your name on.
Que él ha escrito tu nombre sobre.
Nations.
Naciones.
And there's a ministry.
Y hay un ministerio.
That has your name on it.
Que tiene tu nombre.
And the Lord says it's time to come up.
El Señor dice que
it's time to come higher.
Y venir más alto.
Because the season is fast approaching.
Porque la temporada
and so
está
you must position yourselves.
Tiene que posicionarse.
Because there's going to come, it's like a great wind is going to come.
Va a venir un viento recio.
And this great wind is going to push you.
Y este viento recio lo
and va you've got to be ready because it's the Lord thrusting you into what He's called you to.
Y tiene que estar listo porque Dios te está
it's
guiando.
The Lord thrusting you, it's the answer for the nations.
Es Dios lanzándote la respuesta a las naciones.
And there's a great multitude of people.
Y hay un multitud de pueblos.
That they need to hear your testimony.
Que necesita escuchar tu
But
testimony.
More importantly, they need to see your testimony.
Pero aún más importante, ver tu testimony.
They need to see what the Lord has done on the inside of you.
Tiene que ver lo que Dios ha hecho dentro de ti.
Because what the Lord has done is great.
Porque lo que Dios ha hecho es grande.
And he is greatly to be praised for what he has done in your life.
Y él es digno de ser alabado por lo que ha hecho en tu vida.
Because the enemy tried to take you out.
Porque el enemigo tuvo
The enemy tried to remove you from this earth.
Quiso removerte de la tierra.
Because he can see the spiritual motion in your guys' life.
Porque puede ver la emoción, el espíritu en su
And
vida.
There's a people that need to hear the word that God has placed in your belly.
Hay un pueblo que necesita escuchar la palabra que está puesta
And
en su vientre.
There's a people that need to be birthed through your belly.
Y hay un pueblo que tiene que ser parido de tu vientre.
And I hear the Lord say it like this.
Y escucho que el Señor lo dice así.
What looks small will turn out to be big.
Lo que parece pequeño será grande.
What looks minor
lo que parece menor
will turn out to be major.
Va a ser mayor.
And so the Lord says, do not be dismayed.
Y el Señor dice, no se preocupe.
Nor look at what you see with your natural eyes.
Y mire lo que ve con su ojo natural.
The Lord says, look
el Señor dice,
with
mira,
your spiritual eyes, son.
Con tu ojo espiritual,
For hijo. Just as the cloud was as large as the palm of his hands,
porque así como la nube fue de la
and
palma
yet
de su mano,
the rain came,
y aún llegó la lluvia.
The Lord says, what you see is small,
el Señor dice, lo que ves es pequeño,
but what I will bring you is great.
Pero lo que te traeré será grande.
And the Lord says, you keep plowing,
el Señor dice, sigue
and you
arando.
Keep plowing,
sigue arando.
For what I'm about to do on the inside of you,
porque lo que voy a hacer dentro
and
de
I hear the Lord, there's a work that I will do on the inside of you,
el Señor dice, hará un trabajo dentro
because
de
I need to change some things
tengo que cambiar algunas cosas,
so that you can be aligned
para que seas alineado
with where I'm taking you.
A donde te llevo.
What you've done up to this point is okay, it's good, you are in right standing with me. But you have learned some things from this person you've been under
pero has aprendido cosas debajo de una persona,
that the Lord is going to switch. He's going to turn it off.
Que el Señor lo va a pagar, lo va a cambiar.
And he's going to put it on you
te lo va a poner encima.
A new thing.
Una cosa nueva.
A double portion.
Doble porción.
Where the miracles will be like that of a double portion.
Donde los milagros serán doble porción.
But the character of which you do not need will be completely stripped.
Pero el carácter que no necesita será estirpado.
The Lord says, in your hands are miracles, signs, and wonders.
El Señor dice, en tu mano hay milagros, señales y prodigios.
In your ministry shall be miracles, signs, and wonders.
En tu ministerio milagros, señales y prodigios.
And you will start off in one nation, in one area.
Y comenzarás en un área, en una nación.
And within 7 to 10 years
y de 7 a 10 años,
you will have churches throughout the nation.
Tendrás iglesias sobre las naciones.
The Lord says be slow.
Señor dice, camina
be
lento.
Slow to build.
Lento para edificar.
Be slow to build.
Lento para edificar.
For the foundation must be secure.
Porque la fundación tiene que ser
the asegurada. Foundation must go deeper.
La fundación tiene que ser profunda.
For what I will build in you and through you and your wife
porque lo que voy a edificar en ti, a través
will
de ti,
be
tu
great,
esposa.
It will be grand, and it will touch the nations.
Será grande y tocará las naciones.
Father, right now, now, receive it in the name of Jesus. Father, I declare it so over their lives.
Padre, lo declaro sobre ellos.
And I see somebody that you guys love.
Y veo a alguien que ustedes aman.
That right now they're sick.
Que ahora está enfermo.
And the Lord says, I'm sending my healing messenger.
Y el Señor dice, envío mi mensajero
on your behalf.
De parte de ti.
And they will be healed.
Serán sanos.
For you will no longer have to worry about that.
Ya no tendrás que preocuparte
it will
de
no
eso.
Longer be a burden.
Ya no será una carga.
So that you can move forward.
Para que puedas caminar
For
hacia
it is time to run.
Porque es el tiempo de correr.
But build slow.
Y edificar lento.
Run.
Correr.
But build slow.
Edificar lento.
Run.
Corre.
But you will build little by little.
Pero edificarás poco a poco.
So don't worry about that person, the
no
Lord
te preocupes
says.
Por esa persona,
She will be fine.
Ella va a estar bien.
Because I'm healing her even now.
Porque la estoy sanando aún
Father,
ahora.
We send forth that messenger
Padre,
of healing
ese mensajero de
and sanidad. Declare her healing.
Y declaramos su
her body is whole.
Su cuerpo completo.
All disease is gone now.
Toda enfermedad se
I command
ahora.
It to loose her body.
Now,
in the name of Jesus,
en el nombre de Jesús.
Divine health,
Salud divina.
The blood of the Lamb, cleanse her now.
La sangre del cordero,
the
la
blood of the Lamb,
la sangre del cordero.
Yes, Lord.
Sí, Señor.
Resurrection life.
La vida de resurrección.
I keep seeing the story where the centurion soldier was told it is done.
Escucho, sigo viendo la,
the Lord
la
wants you to know it is done.
Del soldado
sí it
murió.
Is done.
Está hecho.
It is done
Está hecho.
Because he loves you,
porque él te ama.
And it's time to move forward without the concern.
Y es tiempo de caminar hacia adelante sin la preocupación.
Yes, Lord. And there's even a people around you
y hay un pueblo alrededor de ti
that are ready to follow
que están listos para seguir.
They're ready to do whatever you tell them to do.
Están listos para hacer lo que le digas.
And the Lord says the season is going to come quick upon you.
Y el Señor dice la temporada viene rápido.
There will be a tarrying.
Va a ser una espera.
And then there will be a building.
Y después va a ser una
There will be a waiting.
Va a haber una espera.
And then there will be a building.
Y después edificar.
There will be a time and a season.
Va a haber tiempo y temporada.
To heal.
Para sanar.
For that reconstruction,
para la reconstrucción,
the removal of the character of the one you were under,
remover del carácter del cual estabas debajo,
and for the double portion to take hold,
y para la doble porción,
and then after that it'll be done.
Y después de ahí será hecho.
It'll be done,
será hecho,
and it shall be so, says the Lord.
Y será así, dice el Señor.
I thank you for that, Father. Hallelujah. Just come on, go ahead. You. The Lord wants to take you higher. The Lord is looking to put you on a higher platform. It has mainly to do with what you do as far as work and everything, because he wants to bring increase to you. And so the Lord says, I've been dealing with you on a few things, and you're kind of like, oh, I'm not sure if this is God. So it's not that you're in disobedience or anything, it's you're just trying to figure out to make sure you do the right thing. Okay? And so the Lord said, it is him that's speaking to you. It is him that's telling you to let go. It is him that's telling you move on. It is him that's telling you. And what he's telling me is that if you'll do it, you know, if you let go of something that needs to be freed and it belongs to you, it'll always come back. But sometimes you've got to let it go so it knows that it's free. And when it comes back on its own, it loves different. It talks different. It acts different. Because it's not feeling like if it's being held, it knows it's free. And so the Lord wants you to know, let it go. Let it be free. And it'll return. And in the space in between, you just get yourself right. You just fall in love with God like you've never fallen in love with him before. Because he's preparing you for what's next. It's great. It's greater than what you can imagine. There's business that God wants to open up to you. There are things that God wants to open up to you that you've never even thought of. But through the business realm, he's going to open up your mind. He's going to open up doors for you. If you were to know right now, you'd think they're impossible. So you got to walk through the first one first. You've got to allow God to do what he wants to do right now so that he can prepare you for everything else. But there are great doors that will be open before you. But you've got to take this first test of faith. Because you don't want to let go. It's hard. It's very, very, very hard. But God has been speaking to you. And he wants you to know that it's been him. It's not you. It's not your emotions. It's not the people around you. Whatever else the whispers have told you, it's not so. It is God. Because if not, you'll stay stuck and you won't move into what God has for you. And they won't realize that they want to be right where they're at. And you got to let them realize that for themselves. But God loves you, and he'll do it for you. Amen. Father, we worship you. We exalt you, Lord. We exalt you, Father. You are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy. There is none like you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Listen, why don't we all just stand for a moment? Just stand. Come on. Yes, Lord. I believe that we're in a season of renewing our covenant with God.
Yo creo que estamos en una temporada de renovar el pacto con
Dios. You got to put the translator a little bit higher. And if you could lower those filler speakers, because they're the ones that are taken away. Praise God. I'm looking for a scripture here.
Estoy buscando una escritura acá.
Let's go to John 7. 37 to 39. John 7, 37 to 39. I want you to understand today that covenant, the covenant promises of God, along with your response, are going to create greater intimacy between you and God. This intimacy will impregnate you with what God has for you. Will impregnate you with God's heart for your life, his will, his provision, his promises, so that you can birth forth what is his perfect will for your life. And so it says it this way in John 7. Now on the last and most important day of the feast, Jesus stood and called out in a loud voice, "If anyone is thirsty, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me, who adheres to, trusts in, and relies on me, as the scripture has said, from his innermost being will flow continually rivers of living water." God wants to open up new springs on the inside of you for fresh water to come forth.
Dios quiere abrir pozos nuevos dentro de ti para que salga agua fresca.
Fresh water.
Agua fresca.
For your life.
Para tu vida.
And the life of those around you.
Y la vida de aquellos que te rodean.
And it all comes back to covenant.
Y todo regresa al pacto.
It all comes back to his love for you.
Todo regresa su amor por ti.
It all comes back to Jesus.
Todo regresa a Jesús.
Being sent because he loves you.
Fue enviado porque te ama.
And you responding.
Y tu respuesta.
Because you love him now.
Porque le amas.
But he loved you first.
Pero te amo primero.
So I believe that God is reminding many of us.
Yo creo que Dios nos está recordando a muchos
of his covenant promises.
De su pacto de promesas.
And if you want to commit today,
si te quieres comprometer,
to respond to those covenant promises,
para responder esas promesas de pacto,
I just want you to come to the altar.
Quiero que vengas al altar.
Come to the altar today.
Ven al altar hoy.
And renew your vows with the Lord.
Y renueve tu pacto.
Renew your covenant promise with God. And I believe that as you renew your covenant promise, there's going to come on you a new grace to do what God has called you to do, a new grace to respond to his covenant promise. And as you respond, God's going to make room on the earth. He's going to make room on the earth for you. He's going to make room on the earth for the promises he made to you. Room on the earth for those things to come to pass. Come on, just come to the altar and lift up your hands.
Yes to your covenant, yes to your covenant.
Come on, just sing it out to him.
Yes to your way, yes to your covenant, yes to your covenant, yes to your will,
yes to your ways,
Yes to your covenant.
Come on, just tell them yes. Come on, let them know.
Yes to your way.
Come on, make it a declaration today.
Yes to your covenant. Yes to your will. Yes to your ways. Yes to your covenant. Yes to your covenant. Yes to your will. Yes to your ways. Yes to your covenant. Yes to your covenant. Yes to your will. Yes to your ways.
Barry, I just heard the Lord tell me this. The Lord says, son, get everything fixed, get everything ready, get everything aligned by the end of this year. Because if the promises of God are going to come to pass in your life, if this business is going to even begin, the idea has to come to fruition. The idea has to be seen. The idea has to be believed. And so the Lord says, son, take the rest of this year to get things aligned. Take the rest of this year to get your house aligned. Take the rest of this year to get your marriage aligned. And if you'll align everything that needs to be aligned this year within the home, not only will that, the idea of that business, but you'll even begin to see the fruit. In other words, the idea will begin to give form. The business will begin to give shape. You'll begin to understand things that you don't normally understand because the God is going to begin to give a shape in your mind, but you've got to believe it and you've got to be able to see it on the inside. But if you'll believe it and you'll see it, the Lord says, and you'll align everything, next year will be the beginning of my promises coming to pass for your life, says the Lord. Alignment is key, son. Alignment is key. Alignment is key. Father, right now, I declare an alignment. Yes, Lord, now.
We will obey every word that you say.
Father, we worship you. All of you who are up here at the altar, just lift up your hands. Say, Father, I see your promises. And I commit today to respond to your covenant promise. I believe with all my heart and know with all my soul that you will cause the promises to come to pass. You will cause them to come alive as I make your word alive. As your word becomes operative, energized within me, it will effectively bring your promises to pass. Father, I believe it today. And I receive the grace to act on the word that you have released in my life in such a way that it reveals my covenant with you, so that your covenant promises can come to pass. I believe it today and declare my eyes are open to see it. For I shall surely walk into what the Lord has said. Amen and amen and amen.